And Greg Watson's going to join us right now. Since Tyler was talking about Greg a little bit, Greg's up here and asking a few questions. Getting a listen to High School Sports Zone here on SportsNetUSA.net. All your Sonora fans, make sure the next two games you can tune them live right here on SportsNetUSA.net. Tomorrow night versus Sunny Hills, and Tuesday night at 7:30 p.m. versus your rivals, the Habra Highlanders. Now, Greg, you listen to Tyler there a little bit. Is that a true statement? You know, sometimes you get frustrated at not getting the ball down to you, having to run the quick and running gun offense?
I actually like it a lot better when we're in transition. I think that's when we're at our best, especially the last few days. I've been watching a lot of film. And when we just get out and go, that's, I think, what our best offense is, because we're not running a set play or anything. We're just really getting the ball and just going attacking. A lot of times, I think our best weapon is like if they score on us, if we just get the ball really quick and just run down the court, come back and score, you know, 2 points there, 2 points, it just negates their play. And so I really like that. Yeah, sometimes it's frustrating, you know, running set plays when it's not all designed around me. But I mean, really, we got four guys that are great shooters. Everyone else can shoot the ball really well. And I think we got other guys that are great drivers too. And so I think that those are really lethal weapons. And you know, if they go in and attack the basket, I'd just like to be there to try to get the rebound and put it up if they miss. And so
right, be there, right place, right time, right?
Yeah, right place, right time.
Now, how hard sometimes is it? I mean, you took on Wimberly, who's a pretty tall guy, and he, you know, and Ryan Hall underneath the basket. Those are pretty tough guys. How difficult is for you to guard? I mean, those La Habra defenders, including Preston Sachs.
Yeah. I mean, they've got three guys that are my size, and so they're all really good players. Ryan Hall played on the tri-ball team I was with on a lower level, and he's a really great athlete. I think he's improved a lot since last year, and I think he's improved a lot since the summer. And so, yeah, and then Wimberly, too. Since freshman year, he's just been a great player. So, and Sax is, you know, he focuses a lot on football, but he's a good athlete too. So, you know, going up against them is hard, but it's not like, you know, it's one big against three, because, I mean, that would just mean it's one against three. I got four guys out on the court that are helping me. And so, a lot of times, I mean, the height does help, but you could definitely tell from film that they were getting more rebounds and better shots off that. But, you know, hopefully we can use our speed against them. And really, if we box out, I mean, height doesn't mean anything if we can really get at them from the beginning. So,
now, you mentioned improvement in that answer. And, you know, it's something that I wanted to mention, too, is that I kid you not, every time I talk to Coach Murphy about you, he's got nothing but praise about how much you've improved and progressed during your time here at Sonora. What are some of the things on and off the court, you know, that you've really taken to heart and learned during your time here at Sonora?
I think every year, you know, you learn something new. I think freshman year I learned how to rebound. That's something I try to keep up every time since. You know, it was a lot of, we wouldn't run anything into the post, so the only way I could get any points is if I got the ball, put it up myself off rebound. So I think I learned that. And, you know, just big improvements on defense. I still have a lot to go with that, but, yeah, everyone's laughing. But I think I've gotten to be a better defensive player just recently on one-on-one. I've been trying to get in more of a stance so that a lot of players try to take me out from where I like to be in the post and try to drive on me more. So I've been trying to improve on that. I think the biggest improvement I've just made is in the post, being able to attack them, learning how to counter everything they've got. If the guy's on you, you know, you've got to do an up and under if they're going to, you know, bite for that hook shot. So you got to go in and do an up and under. And I mean, even today we had to work on it. Chris over here was helping me out because, I mean, I've kind of gotten away from that in the last few days. So we've been working on that. So I don't know. It's just a little bit here, a little bit there.
Hey, Greg, taking the next question out of my mouth there. I was about to ask you about that post game because I've noticed the improvements that you've made as well. And I mean, my last question, you know, obviously going up against, you know, Marcus Preston and Ryan is tough. But, I mean, when you played Montebello and a guy is 6'11", you know, what's your tactic going up against somebody who's even bigger than you?
Yeah, that was probably our worst game overall as a team. Our other six losses have been basically one play difference, and we win that game. So I think that we didn't execute well in that game, and I think I didn't execute well. I've played against him a lot in practicing with him, and what I just try to do is more mid-range jump shots, which I got a few of in the second half. But a lot of times, I think the hook shots, I mean, it's great. If you know, are in the right position, it doesn't even matter about height. He might have a little bit on you, but you can still kind of get it over. And he doesn't really jump for up fakes much, that he doesn't, you know, go for that. He's tall enough that he knows he doesn't have to jump anymore. He learned that because after a few years of playing. So, yeah, I just kind of feel how he's playing me, and then, you know, go from there. So if he's trying to sit in the post more, then do a little bit of mid-range jump shot. And if I do get the ball in the post, I try to do a few hook shots, but it wasn't the best game for me. I don't think I executed as well. And, you know, I think all of us would like to go back and change that a little bit.
Well, you know, going back, you talked about film and everything and watching those games. What are you going to change differently going into the Sunny Hills La Habra game, if anything?
Sunny Hills, I think that we had a lot of times that we played pretty good defense, and then we had a lot of times where we played pretty good defense for the first three passes, and then we just let up. I think the biggest thing is that there's, you know, a ton of time on that shot clock, and we got to play defense until that time runs out. And, you know, until that shot goes up, we got to be playing defense. And then right when that shot goes up, we got to box out and get the ball after, because a lot of times, you know, we just are mentally unfocused after a while, and it's hard to play defense. You know, everyone likes to play offense. Not as many people want to play defense, and I know I'm not one of them, you know, that wants to play defense hard the whole time, but you got to play defense. You got to stop teams. So against Sunny Hills, I really think that we have to play, you know, defense all the way through the clock. I think that would be our biggest thing. For La Habra, I think we took 36, 37 threes, and, you know, only made 9 of them. We really got to attack the paint. They had a higher percentage shooting, and really that was because of their shot selection. And so we got to really attack the paint, even though they like to be in the their zone defense, and they got big guys.
So maybe get the ball to you more, huh?
Well, yeah, you know, that's good, but a lot of times even getting into the high post makes them collapse, and we just kick it back out. And I'm not talking about, like, all right, we have to make every shot in the paint. Our just mid-range shots can be better, especially if, you know, ball movement can really help on that. So I think against La Habra, we'll really have to move the ball better and try to look to attack a few times, you know. Driving in from the guard position, even though it kind of seems daunting with all those bigs there, I know that we can do it. We have good guards. They're quick, as you've seen, and so they can get to the rim if they you know, really put our mind to it. So
definitely. Well, Greg, thank you so much for joining us, and we'll wish you the best of luck this week and next week. All right, David Salazar is good.